makes it grow. Its energy surrounds us and binds us.
There's been a great disturbance in the Force. Welcome to the next episode of the Red Cup Review. I'm your host, Rob Banks, and today we're looking at the Hot Toys 1/6 scale movie masterpiece series number 369 Yoda figure from The Empire Strikes Back. Let's get a nice close-up of this beauty right here. Yoda comes with a wide assortment of accessories, everything you'd expect for him to have for when Luke visits him on Dagobah. Check him out. He's got rooted hair. I know a lot of people, especially the 1/6 community, love their rooted hair. I'm not a fan of it, perhaps. I actually like sculpted hair, but on this figure, it works exceptionally well. You kind of need it. In the prototype, he had sculpted hair. They changed it to the rooted hair, and it works excellently. Let's turn it around and get a nice look at the rooted hair. Yoda comes with a really nice base this time. You know, a lot of the Hot Toys figures lately haven't been coming with bases besides your regular standard base. This works perfectly for him. It's a nice little Dagobah scene. He's got a couple of floating rocks to make it look like he's using the Force. He's got a nice log to sit on or a tree to climb up in. Personally, I think every single Hot Toy figure for the price you're paying should come with not only a regular stand, but a diorama type stand like this, because I would always have my figures in a little bit of a diorama stand as such. All right, you good? We got that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's get right into his accessories. He comes with two head sculpts. Let's get a close-up on the second head sculpt here, which is his Force-using head sculpt. When he closes his eyes and he starts manipulating the X-Wing fighter in the movie Empire Strikes Back, he shows Luke what's up. He shows him that there is no try. It's a very good head sculpt. It also has the rooted hair. Nice, calm, serene. That's the head sculpt you would probably use to make it look like he's floating the rocks in the photos themselves. He's got the two hands, two extra hands for gripping his walking stick. He has two Force using hands. We'll get into those in a minute. He has his little Yoda lamp, and I would actually show you the light up feature. The lamp actually does light up, but for some reason on the bottom, Hot Toys made the screw hole insanely small, to the point where even eyeglass screwdriver wouldn't work. So the little on-off switch there, I wasn't able to open it up without stripping the screw, so I decided not to do it. So you guys are just gonna have to use your imagination.
Maybe you could try the head of a tweezer or something later.
Yeah, exactly. It's an excellent sculpted piece. It's just, it ain't working for me to it ain't gonna be worth it for me to do that, to open it up and risk breaking the screw. He also comes with his little lightsaber thingy that he steals from Luke. It's actually a light, but it's the thing that he obviously in the movie looks like a lightsaber to him, where he's doing the mine, you know, when he's beating on R2. He comes with his, Luke's little box, I guess, that he unloads and keeps his little Scooby snacks in, or whatever you want to call it, his protein bars, and an extra piece right here for the floating effect for the rocks that he has. The problem with the floaty effect thing over here is that this rock that it's meant for is kind of heavy, so it kind of bends forward a little bit. I mean, that's why I'm using this stand in particular, the straight up and down one. So be careful when using that. Also, when sliding them inside the pegs, be careful not to jam it in there too bad, because you might snap the actual invisible little stand piece here. Okay, let's get into the articulation of Yoda. Get a nice close-up on this. Let's get the base to the side. You got some nice detail on his little walking cane. Yoda's got all your standard articulation. Those who are used to dealing with Hot Toys, for those of you who are not used to dealing with the Hot Toys, remember these figures are delicate. They're also very expensive. Yoda comes in at about a $200 price point, so you want to be, you know, a little extra careful when not experienced, you know, when it comes to posing and stuff. Arms move up and down, good range of motion here. The hand pegs, he comes with an extra set of hand pegs in case you snap yours, like every Hot Toys usually does. A little bit of rotation in the wrist there, and the in and out movement as well. Chest has nice range of motion. Get him a nice twist up and down. Double jointed at the knees, rotation at the ankles. Shoulder ball joints. His head, he gets really, really good range of motion when looking down. Not so much when looking up. You're pretty much just going to get a straight on look when it comes to Yoda. I wish his head would have been able to look back a little bit as if he was like looking up into the sky, kind of like when Luke is taking off in his X-Wing. That would have been nice, but I guess as you're going to have to cock the body back and kind of work with it if that's the thing you'd like to do. Okay, Yoda was sculpted by Joseph Tsang. And he was also painted by Joseph Tsang and J.C. Hong, for those of you who are familiar with the people who work with Hot Toys. As far as my review itself, the sculpt I'm going to give 4 cups to because screen accuracy. It looks more like a younger Yoda. Older than he does in the prequels, younger, however, than he does in Empire Strikes Back. He should have been a little bit more gaunt and thin in the face. Both head sculpts, even though the head sculpts are excellent, it's obviously Yoda. It looks very much like him, but not perfect screen accuracy, so I'm docking it a point. Paint at 4.5 cups. Paint is excellent. It's got a very good use of wash in certain points. If you want to close up really a lot on the head sculpt right here, you're probably not going to notice it through the camera, but on just certain points of the head, there's a little bit of gloss finish on the top, where like his veins would run through the top of his head, and it almost gives it this, like there's like a little bit of moisture on the skin, like a sweat feel. Very, very subtle, very good paint work there.
He's got swamp head.
He definitely does have swamp head.
Not to be confused with swamp butt.
The outfit I'm gonna give 3 cups to, because although ripped and tattered in certain areas, it doesn't really fall as well as it does in the movies. This is a toy, however, you can't expect 100% accuracy. It also should have been stained a little bit more. He does live in a swamp. It shouldn't be so clean. And it should have been a little bit more tattered looking. Maybe use a different material, so to speak. The articulation, I'm giving 4 cups to. I'm docking the point because of the head sculpt. The head neck articulation, that is. The accessories, I'm giving 5 plus. And here's a quick comparison shot between the Yoda, the 1/6 scale Luke Bespin version, and the Sideshow R2-D2, since the Hot Toys one's not out yet. Yoda with the different head sculpt on, manipulating the Force, showing Luke how to use it. Here's a quick comparison of Yoda and Luke, size and height-wise. I guess that's pretty accurate. Right? You get an idea of how small Yoda is. You could even throw Yoda up on Luke's back, and he'll actually hold the pose, too. I don't know if this is the head sculpt you want to use for it, but you guys get the idea.
They give him a little twist. There you go.
All right, perfect.
Bring it in. He fell asleep on his back.
Oh, man, Yoda. He does come with everything else you see him in the movie with. His base is excellent paint on the base.
The stand is great, but it needed a snake.
Yeah, he does not have the snake. He should have definitely have had the snake. Good
catch.
Even
if it was just painted onto the stand.
The rocks themselves and pieces of the tree have a nice little gloss finish to it to give it that real wet moss feel. And excellently painted, very sturdy. You can even get Yoda up in the tree. Keep him macking like an OG. Right, come on. Get him there. You know, you work with him, and it'll work. Okay. The fun factor, I'm giving 4 minus cups to, because there's not really much you're going to do with Yoda besides have him standing there posing, waving his hand around, walking with his stick, I don't know, playing with his light.
Dying under a burlap.
Dying in a burlap sack. What else, you know, do you want? Oh, another accessory he comes with that you have to put on is this little neck piece here, which has a nice amount of detail into it. He's got his little Yoda necklace. The packaging, 3 cups too. It's your standard Hot Toy packaging. Nice window dressing here. When you open it up, It's got a couple of shots of the figure himself. Let's see. I think that pretty much covers it. Yoda was voiced by Frank Oz in the movies. Also, he was the main puppeteer. And here's a nice little fun fact I just found out myself. And that in The Empire Strikes Back and Return of the Jedi radio dramas, Yoda's voice was actually done by the famous John Lithgow. So I thought that was pretty cool. From Harry and the Hendersons, John Lithgow. Yeah, I know, right? That's the movie you pull out. Anyways, this is the Hot Toy 1/6 Scale Yoda Movie Master Series number 369. I hope you enjoyed the review. I'm Rob Banks. Be sure to check out The Lair at laironline.net. Awesome comic book store from the Bronx, New York. Also, shout outs to Geekstronomy, and music was provided by Heist Click. I hope you enjoyed the show, and this is your Emperor signing out.